Hey guys, what is up? Today we look at most anticipated icon in the Portuguese history of the game. There were Portuguese fans, Benfica fans, were waiting for Eusebio to drop. Now, we're going to look at his prime icon card today, not his prime moments. He did not release it, unfortunately, for whatever reason whatsoever, being too expensive, whatever. Look at them stats though. Ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at one of the finest icons in the game, a center forward. He comes out as a center forward. I switched him over to strike so I could use him in the team, of course. And let me tell you guys something, this guy did not disappoint. He was a fantastic striker and somebody who brought a lot to the table. One thing that really was apparent was he was so fast, like, oh my god. I genuinely would say this guy was the fastest striker I've ever played with. His prime moments card, I remember using that in a draft. That was so fast, I could not control it. I couldn't contain him. He was just too fast for me. And somebody who's not really that good. Look at that running from behind. Absolutely fantastic. And a great finesse shot there. A great finish from Eusebio. So that's the first thing I want to say, that this guy is absolutely rapid. Secondly, this guy is absolutely sensational at doing skills. He pulls them off really fast. So he does a number of La Croquetas over here. Tries a shot. He misses. But then he does redeem himself with heading that in. Now that's his second pro. The guy has some of the most insane heading in the game. I don't know what it is. I think it's his jumping because he's relatively short. He's got a fantastic shot. Like, even when I'm losing a game, this guy will just bring it back like nothing. He will just take a power shot or he will speed past the defenders. Defenders have no idea how fast this guy is. There is one way for defenders to stop him. That is obviously by using strength, but again, it's a bit difficult to use strength against somebody who's so fast and somebody who's got such a deadly long shot. I just felt like Eusebio is in a league of his own and has to be given a 10 out of 10 only on the basis that he is incredible in this game. He is the unstoppable card. Now, there is only one thing I've got an issue with this card. One issue. The thing is with this card, it is very good, but his baby Eusebio card is also very, very good. So I didn't see a massive difference between prime and baby, because his baby card is the one I'd probably go for, actually. But his prime, obviously, look at that, man. I just felt like his shooting was incredible. Also, I have to say a massive, massive thing about this card. He's got great stamina. Like, this guy could be in extra time and he would be fine. He wouldn't even be tired. It's like, it's crazy to know that some strikers out there have got 94, 95 pace and have that kind of stamina next to it. Usually, excuse me, if you are fast, you sort of like blow that stamina away. This guy just proved to me that he's in a class of his own, because he provided so much stamina to his game. Unlike R9, actually, R9 suffered from that because he didn't have the greatest stamina. But absolutely fantastic striker. I really liked him. He was also really good at passing. He helped out, he assisted, he scored a few goals himself, he assisted. So he was a really good playmaker, hands down, 10 out of 10, fantastic. The only thing I've got to say is, would you pay the extra money to get him when his normal card is fantastic? His normal baby card is fantastic. So that is the only thing. And he doesn't have the most strength. But besides that, you're looking at a complete center forward, an amazing cam, an amazing striker. I actually enjoyed using this guy. It was a pleasure to use. Like I said, he had a crazy long shot on him. He was kind of like, whoa. He was like, imagine him and Cristiano Ronaldo up front. I can't really see the duo getting better, because this guy wins a lot of headers as well, believe it or not. So absolutely fantastic card. Really, really enjoyed him. Absolutely fantastic. Honestly, I can't tell you how good this guy is. If I had the money, I would purchase him. The only reason why I would think of purchasing the prime is because you can't get the baby through SBC. So the prime card is very desirable like that. But if I had coinage wise, if I had to go with coins, then I would buy the baby over the prime, only on the basis that I could get something else as well. Unless I'm Rob Bates in 87, then I'll just probably go and buy the prime moments card instead, because that one, it is incredible. But yeah, absolutely fantastic card, end game card, fantastic, really, really good. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.